Hello friends, this video on organisms and their surroundings part 23 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Let us now look at another important feature of living organism, that is living organisms reproduce. Now this is again you can say it is a very nice ability for living organisms that they can produce more organisms of their kind. So what exactly is reproduction? It is a process by which living organisms produce new organisms similar to themselves. Now when we say that, you think of an elephant. What kind of new organisms would elephant produce? The baby of an elephant would always be a baby elephant. Obviously an elephant will not give birth to say a human baby, right? So the baby of an elephant would be a baby elephant. So basically every organism will produce new organisms which will be similar to themselves. So you talk about human beings, you talk about cat, you talk about bear, you talk about fishes. So everywhere you will see that organisms are capable of giving birth to new organisms which are similar to themselves. So this process is called reproduction. Now, this reproduction is a process which is common to many animals. A lot of animals directly give birth to their young ones, like human beings. They directly give birth to a baby. But a lot of animals, especially the birds, they directly do not give birth to a small bird. They lay eggs, and then the eggs give out new organisms, like how you see here. The eggshell breaks and a new tiny bird comes out of it. So basically here in this case, the mature birds, they directly do not give birth to their young ones, but they lay eggs. Whereas in certain other animals like human beings, they directly give birth to young ones. So these are the two ways by which animals reproduce. Either they directly give birth to young ones, or they lay eggs, and from the eggs, new bonds are formed. Now the question is, why is reproduction necessary? Why do we want organisms to produce more organisms of their kind? Now the very simple answer would be to retain a particular species of living organisms. Now let us for an instant assume that if human beings stop reproducing, if human beings stop giving birth to new human beings, then what would happen? Over a period of time, let's say today we have a fixed number of a fixed population of human beings on this earth. So what will happen? Since there are no more birds, over a period of time, as people grow old, they'll keep dying. So the population will start decreasing. And after a couple of years, what would happen? The entire human species will vanish. There will be no human being, not a single human being left on this earth. So what will happen? We will lose an entire species. Therefore, if we want to retain a particular species, it is very important that reproduction should happen. Reproduction is the only way by which we can retain a species, so that the number of deaths will keep on happening, but at the same time, number of births will also happen. And that's how you'll be able to retain the species. Now, when you talk about types of reproduction, there are broadly two types of reproduction: asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. These are broadly the two different modes of reproduction. Now, there are organisms which reproduce only sexually. For example, human beings. There are organisms which can reproduce both sexually and asexually. For example, plants.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfear.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.